Hello and welcome to the session in which we would look at a consolidation problem that could appear as a CPA simulation on the exam day, or you could see this in your advanced accounting course. It's very important that you understand consolidation from A to Z, at least a basic solid understanding, because on the CPA exam, you might see a simulation like this one. It's very possible you might see a simulation like this one where you are asked to compute the investment account, where you are asked to compute the consolidated net income. You are asked to compute, for example, the account balance sheet for equipment, the consolidated account for the equipment. So you have to be able to understand and be able to answer various questions. This exercise, again, it could be a simulation, an actual simulation, although it might be a little bit on the longer side of simulation, but it could also be in a form of a multiple choice where you are being asked one question. Regardless of the case, whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, I strongly suggest you take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. I am a useful addition to your CPA review course. I can help you understand the material better. By doing so, I can help you with your CPA review course. By doing so, you will pass the exam. What is your risk to try me? 1 month of subscription. Give it a try. I have my resources that are aligned to mirror image your CPA review course. So it's very easy to follow my coursework as well as your CPA review course. Your potential gain is passing the exam. That's the risk reward solution. And if not for anything, take a look at my website to find out how well your university is doing on the CPA exam. Take a look also at my accounting courses. I have plenty of lectures and resources. If you haven't connected with me on LinkedIn, please do so. Take a look at my LinkedIn recommendation. Like this recording, share it with others, connect with me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Reddit. So let's take a look at this exercise that's going to illustrate the consolidation process. In this, there's a lot of information that's going to be in this exercise. So you might, I can generate 15 multiple choice questions from this exercise alone, or I can give it to you as a simulation on the exam day. So be prepared to deal with both. Adam purchased 100% of Ryan's company common stock on January 1st, 2020 by issuing 9,000 shares of $10 par value. So they did not pay cash. They purchased them with stocks. Adam's share had a $15 fair value. Well, I might ask you how much, what's the consideration transferred? It's 9,000 shares times 15. That's the first question I can ask you. On that date, which is January 1st, 2020, Ryan reported net book value of $100,000. However, its equipment with a five-year life remaining was undervalued by $5,000. What does that mean? It means their equipment, we need to add $5,000 to their equipment because it's undervalued in the company's accounting record. Also, Ryan had developed a customer list with an assessed value of $30,000, although no value had been recorded on Ryan's books. Okay. And the customer list has a life of 10 years. Excellent. So what do we need to generate from this question? Well, first thing, again, I could ask you, what is the consideration paid by Adam? How much did Adam pay? Well, let's see. Adam paid 9,000 shares. Let me get the calculator here and keep it up. We're gonna need it for a little bit. Adam paid 9,000 shares and paid the value was $15 per share. Therefore, consideration transferred was $135,000. Now for this $135,000, the net book value of Ryan was $100,000 minus the net book value of Ryan. We have excess of $35,000. That's fine. What are we going to do with this excess? Well, we are told that the equipment are undervalued. Therefore, we're going to allocate $5,000 to the equipment. Remember, this equipment here was undervalued by $5,000. Therefore, I'm going to put down equipment, and I'm going to allocate $5,000 to that equipment. And I'm told this has a five-year life. And because of that, I would know that per year, I'm going to have an amortization expense of $1,000. Also, I'm told the customer list, there's a customer list that's worth $30,000 also. So of the 35, minus 5 for the land, minus 30 for the customer list, voila, I allocated all my excess excess paid, excess amount paid, divided by 10 year. It has a 10 year life. Therefore, I am going to amortize per year 3,000. So good. So that could be, again, at this point, I could ask you, what is the excess amortization per year? I could ask you, what is the excess amortization for equipment? I could ask you, what is the excess amortization for customer list? Okay, and stop there. Or I could have it as part of a simulation as I'm doing this right now. So notice there is no goodwill here. So we're keeping everything clean. Okay, what else are we giving? We are giving Adam and Ryan income statement as of December 31st, 2020, which is end of the first year, and Adam and Ryan income statement as of December 31st, 2021. The first question we're going to try to answer using the equity method, could you compute Adam's investment account on December 31st, 2021, which is after 2 years? So what is the investment account on using the consolidated? On the consolidated will be zero. What is Adam investment account as of December 31st, 2021? Well, what do we have to do? Well, we have to start with our investment account. We started, let me get back the calculator here. I don't know why I took it out. We started with a value. Let me put it right here. We started with a value of 135,000. This was the investment account. In 2020, Ryan earned 110,000. That's going to increase the net income. It's going to increase the investment account, which is we're going to debit the investment account if we're talking debits and credits. Also, Ryan declared and paid 50,000. That's going to reduce our investment account by 50,000. Are we done yet? Absolutely not. What else do we have to worry about, or what else do we have to do? We have to account for that, this excess amortization, because that's additional expenses minus 4,000. Okay. Now this is for year 2021. I'm sorry, for year 2020. So if we want to compute this, if we want to compute the balance as of year December 31st, 2020, because I can ask you about this only. 135 plus 110 minus 50 minus 4, the balance will be 191 if that's the case. I hope I did this right. I did not mistype any answers in there. Now they're asking us about year 2021. Well, in 2021, Ryan earned revenues minus expenses an additional 130,000 of net income. Let me identify those. Ryan declared and paid 40,000 of dividend. Declared, it doesn't matter. That's going to reduce the investment. Then again, we have this 4,000 to account for year after year of this excess amortization, because at least for the next 5 years, because the equipment, we have to chip away the equipment for the next 5 years. Let's see if I did this right. 191 plus 130 minus 40 minus 5. And I'm getting an answer of 276,000. Actually, it should be minus 4, not minus 5, minus 4. I don't know where I get the 5 from. Therefore, the answer will be 277,000. So this is what the investment account will be using the equity method. Okay, we started with 135 plus net income minus dividend minus excess amortization. This was the balance as of December 31st, 2020. Then in 2021, Ryan had income, then they paid dividend, then we have excess amortization with a balance of 277. Okay, so make sure you are comfortable with this. Make sure you are comfortable with this. Okay, let's take a look at another question. I'm gonna erase this because I want to take a look at the second question. What is the consolidated net income for the year ending December 31st, 2021. So they're asking us about this year. What is the consolidated net income? What is the consolidated net income? Well, it's going to be my net income, the parent, when I say mine, the parent net income, plus the subsidiary's net income, right? So let's go through this. The parent net income, 700,000 minus 460, that's going to give us 240. That's 240. That's Adams, which is the parent company. Ryan's net income, which is 250 minus 280 minus 150, which is 130. Then remember, we have to account for the excess amortization now, because we purchase Ryan's company. As a result, we have a customer list to amortize. We have equipment to depreciate more, which is an expense. Well, that's going to reduce this by 4,000. Again, where's the 4,000 coming from? It's this 4,000. Now, if I take 240 plus 130 minus 4, this should be 366. Therefore, what we say is the consolidated net income is 366. We could compute the consolidated income also, obviously, for December 31st, 2020. Net income for Adam, net income for Ryan, minus 4,000, because we're going to be chipping away those balances. Let's take a look at this question. What is the consolidated equipment balance as of December 31st, consolidated equipment balance as of December 31st, 2021? How would this answer be affected by the investment method applied? It will not be affected. So what is the equipment balance? Well, the equipment balance is what? Well, we have, let's see, equipment balance right here. We're dealing with this balance here. It's 500,000 for Adam plus 300,000 for Ryan's company. Now we have 800,000. Remember, we needed to over allocate an additional 5,000 to the equipment account because it was undervalued. That's 5,000. But remember, they're asking us about the consolidated amount, about the equipment balance. Remember, every year we are chipping away $1,000 of depreciation. Therefore, well, we have 2 years because they're asking us about 2021. So I'm going to deduct 2,000, which is 1,000 per year. It's 805 minus 3. The balance is 803. I could also ask you, what is the customer list balance as of December 31st, 2021? Well, we're starting with 30,000, okay? And we're going to chip away 2 years. We're going to chip away 6,000 of this. It will be 24,000. We're not being asked, but just I want you to know this. I'm going to remind you, whether you're an accounting student or a CPA candidate, if you want an additional resource to help you understand your CPA material, please take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. Consider making this investment in your career and your future. The CPA exam is a long-term investment. Don't shortchange yourself. It's worth it. Study hard. Invest in yourself. That's the best investment you can make. Good luck, and of course, stay safe.